coming to this event. This is the annual Lamb Volunteers Appreciation event here, and this year we are hosting it at the Empress Harbor Restaurant. First of all, I'd like to say hello to all of our Lamb volunteers. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you for all my Lamb partners, which is AAEDE, Monterey Park Rotary Club, AAJ, well, Asian American Advancing Justice, and what's my other partner? I have to look. Well, thank you for coming. And my program sponsors, U.S. Bank and Cathay Bank, have representatives here. So is First Choice Bank. Thank you for coming. And I'd like to thank our elected officials and dignitaries for coming here to help us thank our volunteers. Thank you, Hans, our council member. Thank you, City Clerk Vincent. Thank you, Lonnie. And thank you, Norma, our city librarian. Thank you, Janet, our president of our Library Board of Trustees. And thank you, our VIP, Mr. Michael Ng. Okay. And to start tonight's program, I'd like to invite our program student, Julia Cruz, to lead the Pledge of Allegiance for us. Everybody, please stand. Thank you, Julia, for doing this. Come on up.
Okay, ready to begin. Okay. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republics for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Julia.
Thank you.
So before you go, why don't you tell us a little bit about how you get involved with LAMP? So you're our student.
Yes.
What classes are you in?
Right now I'm in the advanced with some, but
hey, teacher.
But when I came to this country in 1996, I start in Alhambra because I live in Alhambra, and my teacher was Lillian. So then, you know, I become resident and decide to be a citizen. And she was my teacher again. So thank you. She's a wonderful person and a teacher. So thank you, everybody, for all the job that you do, because it really helps.
Thank you. Thank you, Julia.
Thank you.
So Julia has spent a lot of time in LAMP as well, besides us. Welcome again. My name is Joyce Chan, and as most of you know, I joined the city as staff recently this year. However, this new job, it really feels like it's coming home to me, because I already have a lot of acquaintances and friends, such as a lot of you in the city. So it just feels right. And I wanted to thank my predecessor and supervisor, Norma Arvizu, for giving me the opportunity. Thank you, Norma. I appreciate it. Okay, so Norma, can you help us welcome our guests? Thank you, Norma.
That was a little precarious. So, first of all, I want to start off by saying that it has taken a lot out of me to bequeath the program to Joyce, but I felt that she was the best person for the job, and so I welcome her as the new literacy program administrator. I am very honored by those who attend every year, including our honored guest, Mike Ng. As you know, most of you, or the new ones who have just joined us, the LAMP Literacy Program Tutor of the Year Award was actually initiated by Mike himself many, many years ago, I believe over 30 years ago. And it continues to honor the most important member of the year who has done astonishing work in her volunteer or his volunteer service. The Lamp Literacy Program is one of the most known programs in the entire state of California. It is recognized as the most comprehensive program in the state, funded by the Department of Education and the State Library grants. But most importantly, I was talking recently to a lot of the Department of Education folks up in Sacramento who were astonished, and I sincerely mean this, astonished at what we do in a library setting. Most campuses do not have the numbers that we generate in payment points, which is how we earn our funds. Most campuses do not have volunteers that still meet the competencies met and done by state credentialed teachers. So these volunteers that are here tonight, most of you, I have to tell you, you are the most incredible people in this program who have brought so much attention to the literacy program in this entire state, and it continues to be recognized as one significant program that will always be recognized as innovative and collaborative with adult campuses and yet independent in the structure of how we generate wonderful literacy adults. So, I thank you all for coming tonight. It is my honor that you still continue with us, some of you who have been here for some time. And just thank you for doing what you do, changing lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Norma. Now, how do you feel? Aren't we a good team? We are the Lamb team. I talked to my staff, and all of them said that seeing all of you every day on a regular basis, weekly, is what we enjoy most at work. So Jose proudly said, everybody knows me. So don't underestimate your presence when you come weekly or daily. Some of you come daily. Some of you do. We really enjoy your company, and we appreciate your work. So, and this is the occasion where we say thank you to all of you. And we don't have a lot of time or opportunity for us to get together and get to know each other like that. Like, for instance, Nancy doesn't know Annabelle. And they've been at LAMP for how many years? So that tells us something, that we are constantly in transition. So please, get to know your neighbors, get to know the ones who are sitting at your table. All of us work for the same goal, for the same program, the LAMP program, okay? Now, without further ado, I'm gonna invite Mike to join us on the podium. And Mr. Mike needs no introduction. It's too long, the introduction. So, Mike, please.
Okay. You know, it's really a wonderful thing tonight to be here. In fact, before we start, Ken and Joyce, you did such a good job of starting us out. And Norma, thank you for welcoming us here. So why don't you turn to the person next to you and say, thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting our LAMP program. Okay. The reason I did that was because it's so cold outside. I was hoping I would hold somebody's hand that's really warm. What happened to what happened to that slide that was up here? Can you turn that slide back on? I just wanted to show something. Uh-oh, that's got my resume here too. Okay. I wanted to just really briefly, time me. If this is more than 2 minutes, then I'll have to donate some money to the library board. But when I was growing up, I needed a tutor, too, because I was an at-risk child before I became an at-risk politician. And I was dyslexic. Let me know what dyslexic means? Yeah, that means I ate too much. No, I was dyslexic. I mean, I couldn't understand words because I would reverse them. And so what I did to understand what words are, I want you to spell the word volunteer. So what I did to understand what that meant would be, first, let's look at the word tier. That is who we serve. Many people who are new immigrants have a lot of tiers. They come to this country. It's hard for them to learn English too quickly, and many of them have a lot of tears, right? Because they're very sad. Now, someone that has a lot of tears does not feel that they're loved. But if you match them with somebody who helps them, then you have someone who has new love. New love. So that's how you get rid of the tears, is someone that's crying meets someone that has a new love of volunteering, a new love of tutoring, a new love for their community. And that's what you all represent. So tonight, we're going to recognize the person that has spent the most number of hours showing her new love to combat the tears and fears and jeers that some of us sometimes face. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you give me a drum roll? But don't collapse the table now, because... Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the Monterey Park Brueggemeyer Library Tutor of the Year Award is the highest level of recognition that can be bestowed on the library on behalf of a tutor or a chopstick. This award is patterned after the Harvey Elperin Award, the first tutor ever recognized in Monterey Park for the most number of hours as a tutor. And Harvey Elperin and our program, as our librarian Norma Arvizu pointed out, was so successful that the state of California adopted the Harvey Elperin Tutor of the Year Award. That's why, as you were saying, not only are we famous for the number of hours in our, but we're famous for the program right here. Give yourselves a round of applause. So, our awardee was an immigrant herself. She felt the personal experience of many, many years where she has spoken a language that she learned that was valuable to many ESL learners that are starting their new lives in a new land. So Daisy first joined the LAMP program in the late 2009. Now, you remember that far back? I can't even remember what I had for dinner last week. She first started as a one-on-one tutor. Later, she responded to our city library, Norma Arvizu's email for an opening for Sunday's conversation class and was given the opportunity and has been teaching ever since then. Over the past few years in her classroom, she's heard heartbreaking stories. Remember the tears? Such as a daughter remembering a father who was gone throughout her childhood, or a defiant woman trying to survive during a dark period in the old country, and sharing the exciting news, such as a father becoming a grandparent for the first time, or a cancer survivor celebrating his 12th anniversary, or people passing citizenship or driver's license tests. And I know Lillian and Vincent have done such a great job. Give them a round of applause, and all of you who taught citizenship under the tutelage of Norma and now Joyce. So, she wants to volunteer a little bit more and then retire 3 or 5 years from now. But she knows that she can only watch only so much TV and win so much millions of dollars at the mahjong table. Which are fair. Did you? Oh, she wrote this. Okay. So it is a great honor. Another drum roll, please. On behalf of the largest community college district in the United States, with many students who benefited from tutoring, including me, that we now present the 2015 Monterey Park Library Tutor of the Year to Daisy Liu. So will everybody stand and give her a standing ovation? And we'd like to ask. Norma, and could we have our library board representative here too?
Is it gold plate? Or,
solid gold.
Oh, right.
No.
And thank you so much, Joyce. Here. And I have a certificate. This is solid gold too.
Oh, great. Where's some money?
It looks like paper.
Come on, Joyce, here. Daisy, would you like to? Daisy? Oh, you're done. Okay. All right. Daisy, come on. Say a few words.
Thank you for the opportunity. It is really, really very rewarding. And I'm going to continue doing so and work together with Joyce.
Give this
and
to
spend
me
more time.
And stay here. For what? Wait. It's a surprise. Besides Lamb staff, only three people in the audience knows. Go ahead. You already have two of those. No. This is the third item you have.
Yes.
No. Now, this will be compatible with the Apple TV and our projector when you teach. Thank you, friends, and the Foundation Ford for sponsoring this. Thank you. Now, we're going to have, we have a short interview footage of Daisy, and the producer is pulling up the footage. Jose Garcia is the producer of all of our videos. Yeah, go ahead, food is coming, no waiting.
I feel that the country has been really good to me, and I like where I live in the city of Monterey Park, and I just feel that is a payback time, and I actually started with the police academy. I was trained as a citizen patrol, but that did not really pan out, and I actually signed up in Garfield Hospital to become a volunteer, but that's not my calling. So, and one day I answer the paper saying, hey, they're looking for tutors in a library, and I applied and got trained. I started as a one-on-one tutor for a couple, 3 months, and then one day I saw an email from Norma saying, hey, we are looking for a tutor for our Sunday class, and is anybody interested? So I volunteered. So then the rest is history. That is English conversation class. I've been teaching that class since. And in between time, I actually subbed a couple of three times for the citizenship preparation class too. The LAMP program definitely presents a very valuable resource for people in this community to come and learn and to explore. And it's just a great program. I'm loving it, and I just feel really good to be part of it. Don't consider it as a chore. Consider it as a good contribution to this to the community, in the way that, and also don't think that is only give. You actually get to take back a whole lot, because for me, it is such a learning, continuing education for me in the process of preparing for the class materials. So, and also you learn a whole lot from your the people sitting in your class. It is actually very mutually beneficial, benefiting. And also the LAMP office has a group of very friendly people, and they are very, very helpful. And you can actually set your own schedule in terms of one-on-one type of tutoring, because you can just set your schedule with your learner. So it's very flexible, and you can set your own schedules. So don't be afraid. Come and join us.
Thank you, Jose, for producing this for us. Isn't that wonderful? Thank you. Can you please pull up the PowerPoint for me too? Thank you. Okay. So, no wonder Daisy has a long waiting list of students, because she's so funny. Okay. Now I'm gonna introduce all of our volunteers to the audience. We're gonna start with the citizenship preparation crowd. And we have Lee Zambrana. Lee, wave your hand. Thank you, Lee. We have Annabelle Chu sitting at the back. Annabelle. And the Lillian Karatani. Okay. And look at my Sunday mob picture. I wanted to rescue him. And I asked them, why are you guys here? Are you guys looking for me? They all said, no. What are we doing? We're waiting for our teacher. I'm like, who's your teacher? Okay, so thank you to all of you. This is our citizenship preparation classes teachers. They teach weekly classes and have a huge follower. Our citizenship students, turnover is very high. Whenever they pass the exam, they either move on to ESL or they exit the program. So it is very difficult to teach when you always have new students in class. So I really appreciate all of your effort in adjusting to that constantly changing audience. It's not easy. I understand that. Thank you so much. And we have our citizenship preparation support, Paul Perez. Hi, Paul. Wave your hand. Paul needs no introduction in the community. We see him in different uniforms and different attire at different times. And then we have Angie Chu sitting at the back. And Angie is Annabelle's sister. Thank you, Angie. And we do not have an image of Fred. And Fred is not here with us tonight. Thank you all of you for supporting our citizenship classes. It's essential, your support, because our students and learners need a lot of practices, and they do not have that support at home. So when we see students coming there every day, literally every day, spend as many hours as we do in the office, and all of you, help them practice. Thank you. Now it's our ESL crowd, and we start with Diana. Diana, hi. Wave your hand. She's right there in the middle table. And then we have Nancy. Nancy sitting at the back, wave your hand. We have Sam. Hi, Sam. I put Sam at the choir table. so it's not quiet anymore. And we have Carolyn. Hi. Okay. So our teachers teach ESL classes of various level. Some are 2-3 times a week. Some are once a week. And we continue with Richard. Is Richard here?
What?
Not yet, huh? Richard, and then we have Rick. Rick also is not here with us tonight. And we have Daisy again. And Patrick is also not with us tonight. So everybody is taking an early start on their vacation. Okay. So thank you to all of you who teach ESL class. It's a huge commitment. You guys don't even want to take vacation. I have to convince you to take a vacation. So that's unbelievable. Thank you to all of you. Right. Patrick, besides teaching one class, he also have one student, and that's Louis, his student. Right, Louis? Okay. So he has been tutoring Louis for a long, is it 15 years? Did I remember correctly? Five? No. A long time. A long time. Yeah, so Patrick is great. Thank you. Now, it's our tutor. So we have Yun Bush here. Yun, raise your hand. Thank you, Yun. And we have Tila. Tila is not here with us tonight because she is flying back from business trip landing at 9 o'clock. And we also have Bob. Is Bob here yet? No? Okay. And we have Carmen, who left the program a while back. And we have Pauline, who is not here, Judy and Ken. None of them are here with us tonight, but they are very committed to their weekly tutoring appointment. We also have Mary, Marilyn, and Diane. And all of them are not here with us, but we appreciate their effort. We also have Sally. Sally, raise your hand. Thank you, Sally. Sally is new to the program. She just joined the tutoring crew maybe in October. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Sally. And we have Diane. Diane, raise your hand. Thank you, Diane. And we have Anne Lu. Thank you, Anne. We have Erin. Thank you, Erin. Erin is also new to the program. And so is Anne, actually. Newer to the program. We also have Helen, who is not here. We have Rosalie, Karen, and Mark, who are not here either. Sorry. I'm sorry. Thank you, Rosalie. And these individuals are Ivy, Lily, Tin, and Simon are not with us tonight. We have that many tutors. And the community enjoys one-on-one tutoring for free. And it's all because of your effort. So give yourself a round of applause. Thank you, all of you, for doing that. And the community really appreciates it. And now,
what happened? Cable loose.
Something loose.
Okay, our office helpers. So besides teachers, tutors, we also have office helpers. I pulled up our powerful duo first. Maya and Zoe, please wave. Okay. They are high school seniors who joined us the last week of September to help me with preparing for the walkathon.
So these are some of the projects that they helped us with. All the, if you remember, we have lawn signs, and those are post those signs on street lamp posts, street lamps. If you remember, they made those by hand. We also have a drink and nutritional bar coupons, and then the new activity corner. They did that for us. So thank you, Zoe, and thank you, Maya. You guys are so great. Thank you so much. And we also have Steven,
who is a bubble professional, bubble and a tutor. So Stephen is not with us tonight. Angela? Angela, hi. Thank you, Angela. Angela is our Monday night super office helper, translator, multitasker, self-proclaimed fireball, but not loose cannon. And Angela signed up along with Zoe, mother and daughter. Thank you. And then we have Sharon at the back. Sharon? Sharon comes to on Sunday to support Denise. Thank you. And the huge bookshelf project? Norma, Angela, inventory that for us. So thank you so much. Along with Zoe and Maya, actually. So at this time, we're going to call out all the LAMP volunteers with a appreciation certificate and then for a group picture. Okay? Give me a second. This time, we're going to introduce our LAMP partners. The first one is Monterey Park Rotary Club. The Rotary Club sponsors our Chinese literacy classes that happens every Saturday. The Chinese literacy classes are for children from first, second, and third grade who are non-native speakers. So Amy is actually our teacher's aide in the class, our youngest volunteer. And oh, is Ivan here? Oh, I didn't see you checking in, that's why. Okay, so we have Ivan, Elsie, Molly, and Amy. And this is how it looks like. It's a very fun class, I must say. So thank you, Rotary Club, for sponsoring this class. Thank you, Ivan, who has been volunteering for the program since this fall? Okay, last fall. Thank you. Thank you for doing that. Oh, you know what? I think it's me pressing a button. Okay, sorry. Okay. So our next partner is Asian American Advancing Justice. No. Eh? Oh, sorry, I skipped. No, it is. It's a college. Oh, yeah. Hold on. So the Claremont Colleges, led by Professor Kathleen Yap, provide us with a lot of students who provide a lot of practices for our citizenship students to practice English and to practice citizenship-related questions and answer those 100 questions, how to fill in and answer N-400 questions at interviews, how should you answer, what should you say, etc. So this past semester, my first time witnessing the storm, we have that storm every Monday and Tuesday night. We have a total of 26 students volunteering for the citizenship program to help our students practice. So that was very much needed. We appreciate our partnership with the Pister College, and we appreciate Kathy's dedication to the program. Unfortunately, Kathy cannot be with us tonight. Our next partner is Asian American Advancing Justice. They partner with us to host citizenship information sessions in English and in Asian languages, and also they help our clients and patrons process N-400 applications free of charge, including completing the fee waiver applications, and also with photos for $5, and legal consultation, plus completion of the application, which is a very tedious process. So we appreciate our partnership with AAJ, and we look forward to serving more who are in need for the program. Our next partner is Asian American Economic Development Enterprise, and we have Anne and Yvonne with us tonight. Anne and Yvonne, wave your hands. Thank you. We are such close partners. They help us co-chair the walkathon, and Yvonne helped me so much with buying stuff, picking up supplies, doing the runaround, and I appreciate your help so much.
They also sponsor our Reading Rockets program. Our Reading Rockets program serves kids who are in the second through fifth grade. At-risk children who are reading two grades below their reading level. So we have our tutors here tonight. We have Lauren, and we have Kevin. Van cannot be here with us tonight. So those are some great shots from our classrooms. And all three are new tutors, but then you guys are wonderful. Thank you so much for supporting our Reading Rockets program. And AEDE is sponsoring the program by paying a stipend for our tutors. So we appreciate that. Thank you so much. Our last partner, but not least, is NAPCA, and it stands for National Asian Pacific. I can't see. No, I can't see my PowerPoint. Okay, and we have Miriam and Harris with us tonight. This is the LA Regional Office Administrators. We have Jenny. Jenny, wave your hand. May cannot be with us tonight, but May and Jenny, it's our, we count them as core staff. We cannot live without Jenny and May. They are often the first point of contact for our patrons, mainly because of the language needs. And May and Jenny knows the LAMP program inside out. They are very helpful to our patrons, and they are very enthusiastic, passionate about helping others. So, Jenny, thank you so much, doing a great job, and thank you, NAPCA, for your service, and it's a wonderful partner working with NAPCA. Thank you so much. Thank you. And at this time, can I ask all our partners, representatives, to come up for a group picture? Miriam, Harris, Anne and Yvonne, Elsie and Ethan, and then nobody from AAJ. Yeah. And at this time, can we ask our former mayor, Hans Liang, current council member, to address our dinner crowd? We're going to have a dinner break after a few words from Hans. Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Joyce. Let's give Joyce a big round of applause for all the work she's done for tonight. It's really a pleasure to be here tonight to celebrate all of the hard work that the volunteers have done throughout the years, also to recognize our new Tutor of the Year, Daisy. You know, it's such a great time right now, being the holidays, and you know, when we think of holiday times, we think about being with our family, but I could see here with the energy and the time that you've all spent together throughout the years through the tutoring and working together, that this is part of your extended family. So I would like to thank again all of the LAMP staff, Norma, Joyce, everybody for taking the time to give back to the community. It's really takes a certain person with a certain character to be selfless enough to first think about somebody else before thinking about themselves. And that's all of you here today. And I want to thank you. And you really are a model for all of us. So thank you and enjoy your evening tonight.
Again, from the podium. How's the food? Good to hear. Thank you. So we're going to wrap up, well, continue by sharing with you what we have achieved together as a team. We're going to go over some milestones from our last fiscal year. So together, we created 86 new citizens. So all the citizenship volunteers, thank you. It's a lot of hard work. We have a total of 77 tutors devoting 4,160 hours. Give yourself a hand, tutors. And together,
We serve 1,200 learners with over 28,000, you read it right, 588 learning hours in the classroom, in tutoring sessions. Thank you. Can you believe those numbers? Those numbers are real. Okay. So one of our milestones this year is our walkathon. We had 60 walkers and we raised a net of $4,844. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our sponsors, AEDE, Cathay Bank, US Bank, Far East National Bank, First Choice Bank, and AAJ. Can we please have Angela Chang and Ann Liu and Francis Low representing the three sponsors that are here with us tonight for a group picture? Thank you so much. Please come up to the stage, Angela, Ann, and Francis. Thank you. Sponsors have been repeating, they're renewing their support for us, and we appreciate it. Thank you so much. So we'd like to share two of our milestones from last year, last fiscal year with you. We launched the Chinese literacy classes last fall, 2014. And this has been so popular in the community and in the library. And I'm always afraid to put out one flyer because then we get a lot of questions and inquiry for the class. So this has been hugely successful due to our sponsorship with the Rotary Club and for our dedicated teachers. So this is one of our milestones for the year. And then Jose Garcia, our senior library clerk, also developed a program called Teacher in a Tablet. How many of you have heard about Teacher in a Tablet? Really? Okay. It's a program that's designed for, a self-paced course that teaches the fundamentals of the English language to those who are at the emergent levels of ESL. Everything is needed to complete the course is contained within the tablet, thus utilizing the potency of the mobile device to create a multi-sensory learning experience. Sorry, I think I need reading glasses now. I really can't read it. So this has been really popular with our learners. Most of you, sure, please. We need to brag.
I don't want to steal her thunder, but I can't help myself. Jose Garcia. Most of you know him as a staff member, the support of the literacy program, but this past year he did something very incredible. He applied for a grant, first time he ever has written a grant in his life. It was called Pitch an Idea to the State Library. And I sat next to him as we spoke to folks up in Sacramento about his idea. And his idea was to create curriculum and load it into an iPad and then lend it out to students who have been on our waiting list. And sometimes we've had close to 300 students waiting on that list. And he actually did this on his own. I didn't help him. He did this on his own. And when he was done, the state librarian was so surprised and amazed by this accomplishment that he's trying to pitch it to all the libraries in the state of California. I'm very proud of him, very proud of him. Thank you, Jose.
Thank you, Jose. Please help me congratulate Jose. He is so talented. Please, nobody steal him from us. Can you see he produces a lot of different things? He produces all the footages. He can do a lot of stuff. Thank goodness for Jose. So this is actually very popular with our students. Students coming back, telling us that they love it, they can learn, and we do pre and post tests. And so far, we have a lot of knowledge gain in payment points that prove that it's very helpful for non-native speakers to learn ESL. So mostly, it's learning sounds, learning phonics, alphabets, some vocabulary, and easy sentences, right? So that worked, and we have 10 iPads that we loan out to students 3 weeks in a time, and they have to return it, except that they have to sign their life off with a liability of $960 if you damage it. So they have to return everything in the package, and not with circulation. They have to return to us. So it has been doing very well, offering this as a new learning platform and help us ease the traffic. And then people are actually using this, and when they come back, more than often, they said, can I borrow it again? And then we said, no, you have to stand in line again for the second time, because we have a constant waiting list of people wanting to borrow this and wanting to borrow this again. So that shows you how popular this milestone is. So thank you, Jose, for doing that for us. So at this time, I'd like to call up all the LAM staff, Angelica, Denise, and Jose. Please help me thank their dedication at work. Jose, Denise, Angelica. And we also have Jenny with us. Jenny, please stand up. Okay. You guys are wonderful to work with. Excellent work. All of these cannot be done without you supporting our volunteer crew. So all of you have been telling me how great our staff is, how nice and caring and diligent they are, and I agree with you. Okay, so thank you so much. Okay. So I'm going to end the evening with my personal thanks for our LAM volunteers. I am humbled and indebted for your kind support and dedication. Thank you for all of you, what you do for LAM and for the community. Thank you. Thank you for joining us tonight. This concludes our program. We still have fried rice and mango pudding coming. Should be, yeah. Special request. Okay. Yeah, thank you. So have a great evening. Enjoy your weekend. Have a great holiday season. If we don't see you again this year, see you next year. Thank you so much.